buddies, hope you're doing well. In today's project, I want to separate tin and lead metal from this solar wire. You may not find this process an economical way to get tin metal or even lead, but I'm just trying to do some chemistry and explore science. And this is about 52 grams of solder wire.
The label says that tin content of this solder wire is 63% by weight and the rest is lead metal. So I have decent amount of tin metal to start extraction process, which is about 31 grams of tin metal alloyed with lead. Refluxing carried out in order to dissolve solder wire. To start chemistry, 200 milliliters of hydrochloric acid seemed to be appropriate, and a few drops of nitric acid would be beneficial to accelerate tin metal oxidation. Every time after addition of nitric acid, solution would turn slightly yellow. That's due to the presence of stannic ion in the solution, which tends to convert to the hexachlorostannic acid. Since tin tetrachloride species is unstable at the elevated temperatures, as soon as the reaction rate increases, white crystals of lead chloride would precipitate. In order to redissolve this white precipitate, we need some extra hydrochloric acid to be added. At the point that there was no more solder wire to be dissolved in acid, solution turned bold yellow. That's due to the conversion of all stannous ion to stannic. Since we have extra oxidizing agent in the solution, which is nitric acid. When the solution of solder wire been completed and solution was still hot, I added some sulfuric acid in order to precipitate lead sulfate. Solution cooled off and refrigerated in order to get all crystals out. There we go, shiny crystals of lead sulfate at the bottom of beaker. Vacuum filtration done to collect all sulfate salt of lead to be processed. Tin metal solution placed on the hot plate to evaporate excess water a bit. To fix solution yellow color and reduce stannic ion back to the stannous, some aluminum powder added to the solution. This is the equation that aluminum involves in the reaction in order to reduce stannic ion to the stannous. First, aluminum reacts with stannic ion and converts it to the metallic tin, and afterwards tin metal reacts with excess stannic ion in the solution and reduces it back to the stannous ion. I just added way more than enough aluminum powder to the solution, and solution turned turbid a bit. To fix that, some activated carbon added to the solution and boiled for 5 minutes. To confirm conversion of stannic ion to stannous, gold testing solution seemed to be a good idea to give us better shot about process. And here is the good news. Solution is saturated with stannous ion. To catch all suspended carbon in the solution, it been filtered through a big piece of column. Let's recover lead metal first. Since lead sulfate isn't water soluble, ammonium chloride solution would be beneficial. An addition of some acetic acid would speed up the process. Since lead bicarbonate is much easier for lead metal to be recovered from, lead would be recovered in a redox reaction which involves carbon as a reducing agent. Lead solution needed to become more expanded in order to be dissolved, so I transfer it to a bigger glassware. When the solution of lead sulfate been completed, solution pH adjusted around 6 with sodium hydroxide. Then some sodium bicarbonate added slowly in order to precipitate lead bicarbonate. Vacuum filtration performed to collect lead bicarbonate for the purpose of removing moisture. Subsequently, lead bicarbonate added to the arc furnace and mixed with some wheat flour as the carbon source. Then arc applied in order to provide heat for reaction between lead bicarbonate and carbon. And eventually, molten lead poured into the tray. Afterward, to clean lead from dirt, it's been remelted. To start recovering tin through electrode deposition, I diluted tin solution to reduce acid strength, preventing tin reoxidation. While solution pH still was quite acidic. Everything been set up and current been passed through the solution from the power supply which I made in previous video. Tin crystal started to grow dull color. It seems diluting tin solution was a bad idea. After dilution, it yielded growing sponge mass of tin metal. Before dilution, I tested solution and sharp tin crystals grew successfully. I had to concentrate solution again. Solution been concentrated and electrode deposition started by lead cathode and graphite anode. I placed lead cathode at the bottom of the cell, allowing crystals growing from the bottom to the top, prevent crystals from falling and losing connection. Otherwise, crystals would become tarnished. Crystals grew successfully, but tin wasn't growing like needles. I wondered it could be due to the formation of oxidizing agents in the solution followed by electrolysis. As you can see, I didn't use tin anode to keep yield isolated. I decided to add some ferrous sulfate as a reducing agent to eliminate oxidizing agent was forming in the solution. After addition of ferrous sulfate, crystals started growing longer, surprisingly. I let solution to run on 4 ampere for about 3 hours. Tin crystals was reached to the graphite anode and been short circuit. So I had separated bigger mass of crystals earlier. I turned power supply off and I filtered solution to concentrate more, to be checked for presence of remaining tin dichloride. Vacuum distillation done in order to concentrate solution. Crystallization done in the freezer and a pure salt have been separated. The salt been tested after dissolving in hydrochloric acid with gold testing solution, and it wasn't what we were looking for. Probably that was aluminum chloride. Again, I concentrated filtrate and I added some pieces of aluminum foil to reduce all recoverable metal ion in the solution. At meantime, sodium bicarbonate added to reduce proton ion concentration, preventing metals redissolution. Recovered black powder added to a porcelain dish and placed on the hot plate. After a while, it starts reacting with air. This powder is probably iron powder from the ferrous sulfate that we use. There wasn't any valuable amount of tin metal in the solution to be recovered.
And eventually, as the result, we managed to recover about 5 grams of, exactly is 5 grams of lead metal. I really didn't expect that for an arc furnace to be capable to recover even as much as 5 grams of lead metal. That's pretty good for exploring science. And here is the crystals of tin metal, pure crystals, which been recovered through electrolysis. I've dipped it in water immediately after washing to prevent oxidation, and it is roughly about 25 grams of tin metal been recovered from 50 grams of solder wire, and it's pretty good since total tin content of solder wire was predicted to be about 31 grams of tin metal per 50 grams of solder wire, but here is about 25 grams, which is pretty good. Anyway, hope you enjoyed. Till next project, see you next time.